Did you know that there are incandescent light bulbs which can last as long as or even longer than LEDs?
What the heck?
I found this at the thrift store a while back. It's by Fight Electric. It's their decade bulbs. Now, they don't make this version anymore, but I looked on their website and they do still sell these decade bulbs in floodlight and flame tip versions. Just not in the standard A-shape versions anymore. But these were their decade bulbs, guaranteed the last 10 years. These were originally sold at Bed Bath & Beyond for $3.99. Saves the replacement cost of 25 standard light bulbs. And these are the 40-watt versions. There's more information on the back here. It says advanced krypton gas for extra long life. Heavy duty 25,000 hour filament, multi filament support resist vibration, heat resistant cement assures no loose bases, and brass base resists corrosion. And it puts out 230 lumens at 40 watts of an average life of 25,000 hours. The trade off of this extremely long life of 25,000 hours is in efficiency, because 230 lumens is just above the typical output of a 25 watt incandescent light bulb. So you're consuming 40 watts of electricity and only getting the equivalent of around 30 watts of light output out of it. You may wonder what kind of applications there are for these kind of bulbs. Well, first of all, it lists on the box vibration service. So these would be useful for things like garage door openers or industrial environments where there's vibration that would cause ordinary incandescent light bulbs to burn out quickly. And these are probably from the era when compact fluorescent light bulbs were popular. They were the big new thing in saving energy. But there are a lot of applications where CFLs are not ideally suited to, such as locations where the light bulb is only going to be used for short amounts of time, such as in a closet or a utility room or a garage. I'm sure everybody who has used CFLs have noticed that they take a while to warm up. So if the light's only going to be on a couple of minutes, you're going to be spending most of that time not getting its full light output out of it. And that kind of repeated short usage can shorten the life of the electronics in the bulb. And also, CFLs were not good in extremely cold and hot temperatures. I know in cold temperatures, they get dimmer and dimmer, and below a certain level, they don't light up at all. Now, that's not such a problem anymore for LEDs. They seem to work okay in the cold, but I definitely wouldn't want to put an LED bulb in my attic, for example, because it gets quite hot up there in the summer. And I don't know if the electronics in an LED bulb would survive that kind of heat. Whereas that's no problem for incandescent bulbs. Also, for example, in an oven, obviously you can't put a CFL or an LED in there. The plastic would melt. Now here's an LED light bulb, which also claims to last for 10 years. But what's the difference? Let's look at the fine print. It says 10-year rated average life based on engineering tested and probability analysis where the lamp is used on average 3 hours per day, 7 days per week. But these bulbs, if we look at the 10-year guarantee, says it's based on normal household use of 7 hours per day. That's why for 10 years of use guaranteed, they say 25,000 hours. But this one that claims to last for 10 years at 3 hours per day, if we do the math, that's 10 years times 365 days per year times 3 hours per day. That's just under 11,000 hours instead of 25,000 hours. There are LED light bulbs which claim to last 25,000 hours, and they do claim it should last for 22.8 years. But if you look at the fine print here, it only has a 3-year warranty. Where these bulbs are actually guaranteed to last for 10 years. And also notice this 3-year warranty is from date of purchase, not the date of first use. So if you buy one of these and it ends up sitting on the shelf for 3 years before you use it, then the first time you try to use it and it burns out right away, you're not going to get your warranty because it already wasted the warranty sitting on the shelf doing nothing. So if you buy LED light bulbs, you expect to get your 3 years of warranty out of it. You have to intend to start using these right away as soon as you buy them. And with any of these bulbs, I don't know how they could ask you to prove that you're only using it for 3 hours per day. I guess they just take it on the honor system that if anybody actually cares enough to return one of these for warranty, they'll probably send you a replacement because they figure most people wouldn't bother to do that. So let's take a look at these light bulbs. They have a frosted coating and it has a brass base just as it advertised. Rather basic etch, Krypton Fate Electric 40 Watt. And on the base here it's stamped in Fate 120 Volt 40 Watt 107. I don't know if that's a date code, maybe 2007. Can't quite see into there to see the shape of the filament. But that's what they look like. It's not quite a soft white coating, it's more of a traditional frosted coating. Of course, I have no viable way of proving that these light bulbs will actually last for 10 years of use, but I have a theory that these might actually just be 240 volt light bulbs, because one way you can get incandescent light bulbs to last for a very long time is to run them at a lower voltage than what they're rated for. I saw a video by Eric Wasatonic in which he showed a couple of 250 volt light bulbs that he has running on 120 volts, and he claims he gets between 3 and 5 years of continuous use out of them. So if we do the math, let's say 4 years of life times 365 days per year times 24 hours per day, that's 35,000 hours of life out of those light bulbs. Well within the realm of 25,000 hours being guaranteed with these bulbs. So I think these might actually be 240 volt light bulbs that are just being sold as 120 volt light bulbs to get this long life. So with that in mind, I have this step up transformer. It takes the 120 volts coming into it. It says 220 volts, but if I stick a meter into this very unsafe universal outlet here and switch it on, you can see we're getting 243 to 244 volts out of it. And for a test of what would happen if you took a standard 120 volt light bulb and run it on 240 volts, I only have one regular 40 watt incandescent light bulb left. And I don't want to burn it out just for this silly experiment. But I do have these 43 watt halogen bulbs. So I guess that's close enough because I wanted to have an equal comparison to these 40 watt decade bulbs. So if I take one of these and put it in our lamp. At first I have it plugged into the 120 volt outlet of this transformer. So that's the bulb in normal operation. Everything is fine. Now I have it plugged into the 240 volt outlet. And once this clock ticks over to 7:45, I'll flip the switch and turn it on. Oh, it burned out right away. Now let's take one of these decade bulbs and put it in our lamp. First, I'll run it on the normal 120 volts so you can get an idea of how bright it is. And now I'll switch over to 240 volts. And when the clock strikes 8:14, I'll turn it on. Well, it should be no surprise that that decade bulb just kept on running on 240 volts until I got tired of it and shut it off. So I really do think those are 240 volt bulbs sold to run on 120 volts for extra long life. And I also found these bulbs from Fight Electric. They're 60 watt vibration service bulbs. And they claim super long life, 14,000 hours at 120 volts. And I'm also running this on 240 volts with my step-up transformer. It's been on for about 5 minutes so far, and it's very happily and brightly glowing. So I don't doubt that these would also last a very long time on 240 volts. And these days, especially with the cheap LED bulbs sold at dollar stores and pound stores, they're really starting to cut corners on them, resulting in them lasting far less than their advertised life. You may have seen on Big Clive's channel where he's taken apart some of those bulbs, and you can see they're reducing the amount of LEDs in the circuit, which means each LED that's left gets an increased current going through it and a shorter life.
Whereas this one has 17 LEDs in it, this one has just 5 LEDs. That is going to really push those. That's more than a watt per LED.
So yes, you may be using less electricity with an LED bulb, but especially with the cheap ones, they may not necessarily last longer than an ordinary incandescent bulb. Well, I didn't get it on video, but just a couple seconds ago, the light suddenly went out, and at first I thought this bulb burned out, but I noticed the little indicator light on the step-up transformer also went out. And it looks like my step-up transformer has died. Now hopefully it just blew a fuse. And I bet if I plug this light bulb back into normal 120 volts, it's going to work perfectly fine. And yes, it does. So the light bulb outlasted the step-up transformer. And yep, just as I suspected, it blew the fuse. Well, I notice here the step-up transformer is rated for 100 watts. Well, these bulbs, they say at 120 volts, they use 54 watts, which means at 240 volts, they use 108 watts. So geez, they sure don't give you much headroom on that rating if it's rated for 100 watts, and if you put a load of 108 watts on it, it blows the fuse.
I have no idea what that's going to look like, so we're all going to find out together, because that's the beauty of this channel. Unscripted, uncensored. Unprofessional sometimes, but what are you going to do?